Hey guys, I'm Catherine, and welcome to Discovery hashtag mindblown. Get ready to use STEM to create the most explosively awesome projects. STEM stands for science, technology, engineering, and math, four of our favorite subjects. Today we're going to be creating our own ecosystem using this weather terrarium.
What's in the box?
An eco what? An ecosystem is a community of living organisms that all interact with each other. We're creating our own little planet Earth, complete with weather systems. Before we begin, make sure you read all the safety warnings, check all the supplies thoroughly, do not expose to extreme temperatures, and make sure an adult is supervising. Let's get started. First, connect the sprinkler to the northern hemisphere. Next, the north meets the south. Make sure the maps are correctly aligned, then twist it clockwise to put the two hemispheres together. Next, connect the anemometer stands and screw it into the base. What in the world does this do? An anemometer is a device that is used to measure wind speed. It's time to catch some wind. Connect the wind collectors to the stand, but make sure they're all facing the same direction. We're going to connect this to the anemometer stand. The rate of rotation of the wind collectors will help us determine wind speed. Next up is the weather vane, which we're going to attach to this stand. The weather vane helps us determine the wind's direction. Which way next? Let's consult with our compass, which goes right above the weather vane. The vane will align with the compass and tell us which way the wind's coming from: north, east, south, or west. Now that we have a way to gauge direction, let's put a thermometer in our ecosystem to tell us the temperature. There are two units of measurement, Celsius and Fahrenheit. It's time to make it rain. We're gonna use this piston to simulate precipitation. Precipitation is rain, snow, sleet, or hail, any weather condition where something is falling from the sky. And there you have it, your own weather terrarium. Let's test this out and try simulating a water cycle. Have a small cup of water and a towel handy. Make sure the piston is closed and slowly pour water into the rain gauge until it's full. Unplug the piston and watch as the water rains down into the globe through the sprinkler. Cool! When the temperature is high enough, the water will turn into vapor and the terrarium will appear foggy. This process is called evaporation. As the warmth continues, the fog will turn into water droplets and condense on the walls. Guess what this is called? You got it, condensation. Over time, the water droplets will grow in size and weight and will cause it to fall. This is called precipitation. And now for some rapid fire facts. Half of the world's species live in tropical rainforests, a very busy ecosystem with many types of plants, animals, fungi, and microorganisms. 40% of Earth's oxygen comes from plants in the tropical rainforests. Now that you've finished your weather terrarium, you can make your own weather report. Track the weather in your backyard using this chart. I hope you enjoyed learning about ecosystems. See you soon!